everybody. As usual, we are going to start our topics, which was business plan. Okay, so we discussed in brief the different titles incorporated in a business plan, and part of that we also discussed about different forms of business organizations working and available throughout the world. The market segmentation process, if you go through the lines, the points, it will make you more easy, okay, to understand. So number one, it says, decide what general market or industry you wish to pursue. That means you're not, you may be going to serve the whole market or a portion of that. So first of all, you have to specify which common market you're going to address with your product. Got it? The first thing you have to do. Then secondly, divide the market into small groups. That means once you have selected that this area or this type of customers we are going to address, then you have to divide the market into small groups, like A, on the basis of characteristics of the customer, the some features of a customer, like geography, division, district, thana, upazila, something like this. So it can be segmented like this. Or it can be demographic, like age, gender, occupation, education, income. Lot of other ways are there. Okay? And thirdly, psychographic, like personality, lifestyle. You see, the different people has got different type of lifestyle. So you can segment your market on the basis of the lifestyle, on the basis of the personality, especially for the official dress. If you are going to sell footwear, suppose, what type of people you need to address first? You have to classify the customers on the basis of personality, like the official dress, or it will be sports type dress. So if it is sports type dress, consider the World Cup, it's just coming up tomorrow. Okay, so a lot of different types of specific goods are being sold out in the market, and the clever people, the smart people are getting the chance. They have already taken the opportunities by selling lot of different types of sport related items, which is very much related with the World Cup. Okay, so you have to understand which lifestyle or which type of person you are going to address with your product. This type of classification is called classification on the basis of personality or psychography. Buying situation. Actually, we are telling that you can segment, you can divide the market in many different ways. This is the second possible way, buying situation. Because the buying power, the buying habit of the people are not same. Okay, so even it depends and it varies from one segment to another. Okay, so how does it work? You see, firstly, desired benefits, product feature. That means, what does the customer desire from the product they are going to buy? First of all, what are the benefits? You have to find out the features of the product. Benefit. What additional benefit you are going to offer with your product? You understand that? This is a part of buying situation. If you want this and that benefit, and if I can offer, you'll get it. Okay? Then usage, rate of use. Is it more frequent or occasional? If it is a dress one, it is a fashion oriented one, it will be occasional, it's not regular. But if it is a casual one, it will be regular. Okay? The dress for university, dress for school, dress for office. So we have got some sort of specialty. For the official dress, only official purposes it will be used. For the school dresses, only for the school. But the casual dresses, only for when you are casual. Okay? So your product will be something like this. What is the objective or the purpose of using the product? What is the timing of using the product? Is it party dress or is it casual dress? Is it sports dress? It depends. Then buying condition. At what point in time the buyers are having time to get your product? Is it after the office time? Is it after the school time? Is it after the university time? Is it after during a special festival? So you have to understand the buying condition of the customer also. Okay. And sometimes you will find that international trade fair. Okay. So many ladies are waiting for the trade fair to buy some particular goods from that fair. in villages, in many villages in Bangladesh, so there are some special trade fair, especially during the time of Pohela Boishak. Okay, so it's a cultural heritage in Bangladesh, and it's supposed to happen just last few months back, last 1 month or 2 months back, it happened throughout the Bangladesh, throughout the country. Okay, so many people working in villages, usually waiting for that fair, when it will come, and they will buy this and that goods. So accordingly, there are people, there are sellers of those particular products to be sold out to those fairs. Okay, so this is also classified.